Anyway, what happens the instant you get sucked into a vacuum?
You die.
Wow.
What? Lightning.
You die instantly from asphyxiation.
No. Oh, Alan. A vacuum. If a human being were to be inside a vacuum, they wouldn't. You wouldn't die instantly. I mean, you wouldn't last long, obviously, because there's no air.
But it wouldn't be any worse than being in, like, Belgium. Or Watford.
How long will we get, then, in this vacuum, if...
Depends how much air you'd breathe in just before you...
I'm now basing an answer on something I saw in a science fiction film. Breathe out, you exhale.
You're right, you shouldn't hold your breath.
But having breathed out, are we talking seconds, minutes, hours, minutes?
Yeah, clearly not hours. You can't, like, survive hours without air. Yeah. Well, gas escaping from your body would make you simultaneously defecate, projectile vomit and urinate. But without...
Just like an astronaut. Like
yes. Yeah. I bet they've done it with small mammals in labs.
I fear they probably have done experiments, and that's how we know. I'm afraid that's how we know. Experiments with animals.
Really?
You can survive with no appreciable long-term problems for a couple of minutes. Yeah, the first sensation
will
be
the
The first sensation will be the moisture of your tongue boiling. The loss of taste may continue for days. They have had accidents involving humans, that's how they know.
So it's like having a very, very strong curry.
If you like.
Your tongue boils and then all your innards fall out.
Yeah. Basically, it's a kind of vindaloo. A vacuum loo. Yeah, it's pretty unpleasant. I mean, avoid it if you see one of those things.
Avoid vacuum.
Don't go in.
What an idiot he was.
Bless. Various experiments and accidents have shown that people can actually survive in a vacuum for a couple of minutes at any rate.